Hi, and welcome to techsith tutorials. In JavaScript, functions call, apply, and bind seems to be doing exactly the same thing, but there's so much confusion around it and when to use it and how it really works. So when I started learning JavaScript, it was so difficult to understand it because there were very little documentation available on this, and whatever I find confused me even further. So based on my understanding so far, I have created this very simple tutorial to explain it to you, the difference between call, apply, and bind. Traditionally, you have objects with properties and methods, and each object would have its own property and its own method. For example, here in object 1, you have its own properties and method, and object 2 has its own properties and method. But in JavaScript, you can do something more interesting. Object 1 can have its own property. Object 2 can have its own property. And you can write methods separately, and using call it, apply, or bind, you can use these methods on these objects. This way, you can write common method for various objects. The best way to actually learn is by coding. So we are going to do some coding here. I'm going to use this wonderful website called jsfiddle.net to actually demonstrate call, apply, and function. So here you can write your HTML in this block, CSS in this block, and JavaScript in this block. And when you click on run, it executes and give the result over here. And the bottom here, I've opened up console as well. So I'm going to start by building an object. So we have an object called obj equal to num2. So this object has a property called num, and it has a value called 2. And I'm going to have a variable add to this equal to function, and it has an argument a, so, and it's also a very simple function. All it does is returns this dot num plus a. So let's say if num is 2 and a is 2, then it will return 4. Now, as you can see, this object does not have any method associated with, like add to this. And this method does not have any property called num. However, it has this, it's returning this.num. So if I wanna take action on this object using this method, I can do it by using a call function. So the way it works is first you would take the method, which is add to this dot call, whichever function you want to execute, you put it first, and then dot call. And here you would pass two arguments. The first argument would be the object you are applying this functions to, calling this function to, so which would be object. And the second argument would be the arguments for the function itself, which would be a here. So the a would be, let's say, if I'm passing 3 here, okay? So the function is this, the object I'm passing here, and the argument is coming from here. Okay, so in a way we are saying function, name function name dot call is object, and then function arguments. This is what's happening. We have a function name dot call, and in the arguments we passing the object, and arguments for the function itself goes here. Okay, so let's console dot log this thing. If you don't know, console.log would basically print out the result of this operation because this function returns this.num plus 8. So if I run this, I'll get 5. So what really happened here is this function was called for this object, and the property of the object was accessed using this.num, and the argument 3 was added to the value because this.num would be 2 plus the argument would be 3 and then the returning 5. So that's what it is. Again, if you have any confusion, a question, feel free to send me an email or post a message there. Okay, now the second thing we're gonna learn is call. Here also what you can do is, let's say if you have multiple arguments, let's say if I have A, B, and C. Okay, and what I'm doing is I'm also adding A, B, and C here. Now how do I pass these three arguments instead of one? So I would simply, I can simply write these arguments here directly. But the first argument has to be the object itself that you are calling this function to. And then the three arguments. So in this case, the result would be 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus the num, which is 2. So 2 plus 1, which is 3, plus 2 is 5, and plus 3 is 8. So if I run this, by the way, you can clear the console by using this. If I run this, I would get the answer 8 here. So that's what the call does. It attaches this function to this object temporarily and then runs it and gives the result back as if it's a part of this object itself. Call is very similar, but instead, as you see here, you have arguments A, B, C. Instead, I can actually create an array here. I can create an array called var array equal to 1, 2, 3. And I can just copy this and paste it here. Instead of call, I'm just going to replace with apply. And instead of this arguments 1, 2, 3, I am going to pass this array of arguments. So it's going to be ARR. So the syntax-wise is not much difference. And it does pretty much exactly the same. So if I call this, let me console this out. And if I'm going to do this, and if I did this, it would also get 8. So I don't have to pass all the argument. I can combine all the argument in an array. That's the only difference between call and apply. Now bind is a little different. How does a bind work? Let's see. So I'm just gonna take some of these things out. Also, let's say if you have another object called object 2, and let's say it has a num value is 5, for example. In this case, I can actually call, apply this object 2 to the same, with the same argument, and it would produce a different result. So in this case, instead of 2, the num would be 5, and so it would give me 3 more, so it would be about 11. Let's see. So it'd be 8 and 11, so as you can see. So this how it's attaching, instead of this object, it's actually applying this object. So that is a use for it. There are other uses for it and other wonderful uses for it. I'll have to create another tutorial for it, but for now, to understand this, this should be sufficient. Now let's look at bind. So let me just remove this object here first and also this stuff first. So here, instead of apply, I can simply say bind. However, this would not give me the result here. So let's see, if I did this, it's actually giving me a function instead of value. So bind is a little bit different. Bind gives me a function which has ability to execute this. So it actually attaches the object, this object, and makes add to this part of, is a method of this object, and gives me back the object in a different way. So if I create another object, so instead of this, I can just simply say, I can create another object called var bound equal to this. So, and I can say, now, when I do the when I bind to this function with this object, I don't really need to pass the argument, because the argument I can directly pass into the executed object. So now, if I just console log this out, instead of console log, I'm just gonna say console dir, and I'm just gonna see what is being returned here. Let me do this. So it gave me a function called bound. So it bounded this object with this method. It did not return me this. This still has to happen. I still need to execute this function to do this. In call and apply, it would just simply giving me the result of this execution of this function. But when I use bind, it does not execute this function. It, you know, it gives me a function back, which I can execute a later time. So if you look at this function bound, there are some interesting things here. You would see this, if you expand it, you would see target function, okay, which is this, add to this, and it has these three arguments here. You would see bound this, which is the object, this guy, as you can see, and it has this property num equal to 2, and then it would have this bounded argument. It's an array. Now, in order to run this, I would have to call this function. So I'm gonna have to call this function bound, and now I don't have to pass, you know, the object, because this object is already bounded to this. So all I have to simply pass is argument, which is A, B, and C. So I can simply do this. In this term, it works more like a call, you know, because you can pass the argument itself. And let's say if I console.log this thing, see how it works. And it would give me 8. So in a nutshell, you have an object, you have a function with a bunch of arguments. You can call using function name call object and argument, you pass it like this. When you do apply, instead of like this, you just pass an array. So that's the only difference. In bind, you first only apply, you only pass the object itself, and then it will return a bound function. And then you can execute this bound function by passing the argument. If it's not clear, if this is not clear, please send me an email and I'll respond it to you. Thank you. If you like this tutorial, please subscribe to my channel, like the video, and provide constructive comment. And if you have a question regarding anything that I've covered in this tutorial, please feel free to actually email me or provide a comment. And if there is any topic that you would like to be covered, then just email me, and I will be able to provide a tutorial on that topic within a week or two.